So we have seen how Islamophobia has unfolded itself over the last few days in the wake of the pandemic, where everyone is suffering. The suffering we have seen is worldwide. It has affected all the countries, Christian countries, Islamic countries, Jewish nations, Hindu countries. So first of all, the pandemic has, or the virus has no religion. But yet we have seen how the, in the context of the pandemic, and focusing on one particular incident at the Nizamuddin Tablighi, and by the way, the culpability of the people who attended the Jamaat has not yet been established perfectly, because the administration, it has been found out that the administration was equally very lethargic when it came to taking action. The administration did not show that kind of a willingness to stop the markers. So the administration is equally responsible for the for the congregation, for the for that religious gathering. So that is a different issue, a law and order issue, which we hope will be looked into, and those responsible for that carelessness, for that lack of seriousness, which is causing the death of so many people, will be punished. That we are not denying. It was very stupid on the part of the Markaz, on the part of the Tablighi. It was absolute lack of sense, carelessness, lack of awareness on their part to have organized such a Jamaat, such a congregation. But why are we giving it a religious color? Why is it being related to that general sense of Islamophobia that we see among people? Why is the incident being communalized? Why is the incident being communalized? Why are the Muslims being criminalized and demonized? We have seen a large group of, large section of media, which is, giving such stupid name to this incident by calling it Corona Jihad, or Muslims are on their way to spread this disease. It has become the hotbed, Nizamuddin, the place where the Markaz is actually located, has become the hotbed of the virus. Well, it is not so, because with time we have seen how the government has located various other hotspots from where the virus seems to be spreading. So it is extremely wrong on the part of the media and the people behind the media, actually, the people who are manipulating the media or using the media or directing the media to create this kind of nuisance, to create this kind of bogey, to create this kind of this environment of phobia among the people, so that yes, people do get scared of Muslims, people avoid Muslims in public places. They look at Muslims as carriers of virus. They look at Muslims as really dangerous, who are out there in the world to kill the fellow Indians. So this atmosphere of phobia, this is basically nothing but the phobia phobia of Islam, phobia of Muslims, to keep people away from Muslims. And on top of that, there were a number of series of fake reports in news regarding Muslims misbehaving, especially the people who attended the Nizamuddin congregation, misbehaving with doctors, with nurses, making lewd gestures at nurses, spitting on the fruits, so that when normal people eat that food, they also get the virus, or creating other kinds of nonsense, pelting stones at the policemen, not cooperating with them. So we have seen most of these reports have been, almost all of them have actually been exposed and found to be fake, but it has done the damage. it has done the damage. More people, I think there are more people in this country who have easy access to fake news, so they'll believe it. The clarification that comes after it, I don't think as many people will learn or know about the clarification, because I personally still have, you know, friends who think that yes, Muslims are wrong, they did spit on the fruits, they did misbehave with the nurse, and then I have to share the link with them to clarify that no, it is not so, it was fake news and it has been exposed. So media here playing a very important role. Now that is Islamophobia in general. Now there's other side to it. There's other side to the Muslims of this country. How many of the media houses have highlighted the relief work that the Muslims are doing in this pandemic? The relief work, not just for the Muslim community, but for all. I have personally known many, many independent volunteers, groups who are not even associated with NGO, but out of sheer honest sense of charity, they are coming out and helping the daily wage laborers, the migrant laborers, people who have suffered severe, people who have suffered economically, who have had, suffered economic losses because of the lockdown that we are all observing, that we are all under this lockdown. So the severe losses that these people have suffered. There are many Muslim men and women out there who are coming out in huge number and helping them out. That side of the Muslims of this country is hardly highlighted, except for a few social media posts here and there which people like us share. But nobody talks about it. The mainstream media does not talk about it at all to show us the good side of the Muslims. There are people that I have known who have, given up their salary. People, IT professionals, businessmen who have given up their savings and collected money from their friends and neighbors and gone on to do relief work. They have visited. So I think that part of the story is hardly highlighted. It is mostly neglected. Though there were some who were responsible for, their carelessness, for that careless and almost callous act of organizing the congregation and, calling people from those countries that were already infected by the virus and leading to so many other people in India catching that virus. But what about the other side of the story? The other side of the Muslim population in this country. Why are we not talking about them? Why are we always demonizing them? Calling them like, like evil people who are out there to kill other Indians. It is their, it's a part of their plan, it's a part of their jihad that Muslims all over the world follow. All that is utter rubbish and ridiculous. The people who have gone out to areas that I'll mention the name of some of them, areas like Malikpur, areas like CIT Road, areas like Hawra, areas like Kansrapara, Kakinara, Kamarhatti. There are boys as young as students who are volunteering themselves in this task, in this relief work. There are some professionals, engineers, some teachers, doctors, businessmen who are using up, who are contributing their savings, their salaries towards this relief work, because they can understand that the people of this country are economically suffering and they will die of hunger. If not anything else, they will die of hunger if they are not if they don't get this relief at the right time, the government we know has passed many schemes for them, but I don't know if that is sufficient or when will it reach them. All those questions are still answered, because I've heard of a family where there are 7 members who will get out of one of the schemes of the government. That family will get only 500 rupees in a month. Now how that family will sustain itself with that 500 rupees? So they need instant help, instant relief, because we know that the lockdown that was called, it was necessary, okay, to save the lives of many, many people who might have got affected by the virus, through mingling and through social interaction. But what was the economic plan for the economically backward section of the society? There was no planning at all. It was post the declaration of the lockdown when the government saw, as if the government does not know, that there are so many crores of people in this country, millions of people in this country, who are daily wage laborers, who are depending on the, who belong to the unorganized economic sector. So, what plans did the government have for them? That it did, it was a post-lockdown announcement thought. Oh, let us do something for these people also. And the government shelved out, dished out a number of schemes for them. But when are the schemes going to reach to them? And we know that the schemes themselves are flawed. They are not, the amount of money allotted in that scheme is not enough for the population. So, in that case, so many of the Muslim organizations, independent volunteers, and let me tell you, there are many mosques which are otherwise locked for prayers. People are not going in those mosques for their regular prayers, but they have become center of relief work. They are distributing the daily ration, they are distributing breakfast, lunch, dinner to the poor section of the society, the poorest section of the society, in fact. There are many who are going out, reaching out to this section of the society and giving them the daily ration, which will at least help them to stay alive